All right, well, if you're curious what I'm doing, it's replacing a strut on the Mini. Strut mount is right here, very easy to get to, and then the rest of the strut is obviously behind the wheel and the suspension. I'm here in my very tiny garage with not a lot of room to work. Just showing you my feet here. This is it. This is all I got. Okay? Not a lot of room to work. We're going to make it work, though, because you got to do what you got to do. All right, got some work lights going. Got the wheel. Got my jack stand on the jack. Start pulling the wheel off. Okay, so now that the wheel's off, what's the problem? You see all that oil right there? That oil is from inside this unit called the strut. It should not be coming out of the top, it should be in the strut, but because it is out of the strut, the car handles like garbage. So we gotta change that whole thing. And then the parts to go with it. Yeah. Super important tip, always have a kneeling pad, cardboard when you're working on a cold concrete floor. And it helps to have one of these. That's a forced air kerosene heater. Woo! Red hot. Of course, on this side of the garage, it's a little cooler, so the passenger side of the car was much more toasty than this side. Anyway, let's get to work. Sometimes we get to hit things with a hammer to take them apart. There we go. And it's apart. Special tool there is a HAMMER001. The next piece that came off here was the lower sway bar link. Attaches to the strut. This is the sway bar. I usually replace these because they're such a pain in the butt. And they're 15 bucks a piece and I never want to do them again. So anytime I do struts, you just order them. Period. Because sometimes you have to destroy them to take them out and then you got nothing. So just have them on hand. Okay, so now we've gotten the main bolt out of the strut that holds a pinch weld together, a pinch tube. Got our lines disconnected, and then we're gonna hit it with a hammer again. And I'm gonna hit it right there. Try not to hit these wires, because if I do, that's bad news. So I'm gonna put the phone down and use my other hand to move these out of the way when I hit. So now the strut tube is disconnected from the steering knuckle. Swing this whole unit around. Move this out of the way a little bit. And now that it is free, I'm going to loosen these top bolts up here and then I can pull the strut. Okay, here we go. Now at this point, the strut is actually free to come out. Let's walk it over to the bench. Come on, strutty, let's go. That, see? That big hole there. Hey, hole, what you doing? So the strut, the thing is, what is it? Well, this lower half is like a shock absorber. And this upper half is the spring. And if you thought they were the same thing, they're not. The spring is what actually holds the car up. The shock absorber absorbs the oscillations generated by the natural frequency of the spring. If we didn't have a shock absorber, when we hit a bump, the spring would continue to oscillate and the car would bounce up and down, which is exactly what this car was doing because the fluid inside the strut is leaking. Now, the fluid leaked and I immediately stopped driving the car because I hate driving a car with anything questionable steering suspension parts. I cannot do it. So we're here replacing it. So here's the other thing. When you are replacing a strut, we're going to reuse this spring. Everything else, except for these rubber mounts here, there's one at the top and one at the bottom, they get replaced. You basically recycle the spring. And so you have to, if you're going to reuse this stuff, it's a bad idea because it's generally beat. You can see that there's, weevils and things living in this. Anyway, it's got 70,000 miles on it. This stuff's all hammered. It's got no more life in it. We're going to replace it all. We're going to refresh it. And I don't like to try to rely on things like these bump stops or the sway bar links. You're there. You put a new mount in. Don't try to save this stuff because you're cheap. Okay? No. No cheap. So the strut has a nut here on the top holding the spring in compression, right? If we take that nut off, this whole thing wants to go boing and spread apart this way, which would be really funny, except this spring is compressed and it generally holds up the weight of a car, which means if I take this nut out without compressing the spring and relieving the stress in it, or actually compressing it and taking the stress off the mount, this nut and this whole assembly would come apart like a shotgun and hit me right in the face. So we're not going to do that. We're going to put on a strut compressor. So a strut compressor are these two large jack screws. I'm going to put a power tool in here and I'm going to compress them. They're going to squeeze together. I'm going to alternate left, right, squeeze together, and then eventually loosen this up by compressing the spring. Being very careful, it's mounted on a vise. Very important. Away from my face. A little too tight. I'm gonna have to reposition these and try this again. I should be able to have this spring be loose up here, and it's not quite where I want it to be. Yeah, it's close enough. I think we're in good shape. All right, this is a few more taps. There we go. That's good. All right. And now we're gonna take out the center nut and the top. Hold that still because that keeps spinning when I hit it with the impact. I can't do that with two hands. Okay, so I got the top nut loose. Pull that out. Put it over there on the bench. Take the strut mount out. There's two washers under here I need to be careful about. I'm not going to reuse that. This is the new one. This is the old one. Always replace this when you replace strut because these get compressed over time and they just cheap insurance. Careful attention to these two washers. They seal the lower bearing. Take the upper hat out. Go, wow, it's kind of nasty. Take my jouncer out. Take my dust boot out. Take my spring off. Ring. Put that over here out of the way where no one's gonna get hurt. Then I gotta take this lower rubber mount out. And then here is my old strut. And oh my gosh, this is so blown. Oh wow, that's really bad. I should not be able to push this down with my finger like I am. Really, really weak. And it should actually spring back on its own. It should come back up, and it is not. Let me show you. So this is the strut from the passenger side. This is the strut from the driver's side. Can you see the problem? Yes, this one rebounds because it has, it's not damaged, it is not blown. You always replace these in pairs because you never assume that the other side is good. And you want the car to be balanced when you go left and right. So we always do struts, all suspension work in pairs. But this is obviously broken. Broken. It's leaking. It's leaking. I push this down and I push this down. It'll bubble around like a cauldron. Look at that. Witch's brew. One funny thing, you're like, oh, Mini's BMW group made in the United Kingdom. Strut, right? And then over here it's like, no, it was actually made in Poland. So where was it made? By the way, the new struts are made in Germany. Actually, I now question this, because it doesn't say made in Germany, it just says Bilstein Germany. Yes, that's a German company, but it doesn't really say where it was made. Alright, well, maybe it was made in Germany. I feel a little better now. A little better. Okay. By the way, Thyssen Krupp, however you want to pronounce it. They make elevators. Who knew? I didn't. Brand new strut. We're gonna put this back together. Okay, so we're all set to put it back together. I first put on my lower spring insulator. So we've got some dots here to line this up. Fits in there like that. Take my gator or dust boot and the jouncer, put them together. That. I'm not using this one because the oil affects them, they rot, the oil breaks down the material. Put our spring back on, wipe off the old oil. Just pull the spring. Nobody likes a dirty spring. Alright, put that on there. Put our announcer on. Washer, put that on there. Strut bearing. We are going to put our new fastener on. I'm going to impact this into place, which is not technically correct, but it's good enough for the people behind us. And it is just the way it is. You can't tell me what to do. I'm the boss. Carefully making sure that the bearing housing all lines up. Making sure that everything is where it's supposed to be. So
last chance before I really seal it. We take off our strut compressor. Strut is now assembled and ready to go back in the car.
So the absolute worst part of this job is to fit this strut back into the steering knuckle here. This pinch bolt is normally very tight. There's a tool that you can buy that helps spread the pinch a little bit so the tube can fit in, but you gotta line up the holes with the top and sort of juggle this around and wiggle it in there. I can't do it holding the camera at all, so I'm gonna put the camera down, and when you see this, it'll be sort of back together. Okay, so the strut is now lined back up. I have a floor jack here because I have to jack up the lower control arm to push this back onto the strut, the steering knuckle back onto the strut. So the other thing is this is the bolt that holds the strut in. You can see that it's got 6 winters worth of rust. We're gonna clean this up and then put it back. Lined up and put it back together using a torque wrench. Click when it gets the correct torque. There we go. Perfect. And then the last step is to use this tool called a torque wrench to make sure everything is tight and that the lug nuts are not over-tightened and not under-tightened, neither which is good. Got that nice loud click there, telling me that I have reached the desired torque. Next step would be, after that's all done, is to go out for a ride. Check them out. That's it. Thanks for watching.